Hey, 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 what's happening, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Rap City. It's your man, Joe Clair. And I am at the Diamond Quasar, where my man Jacob just laces everybody that's in hip-hop. That's where everybody comes. All the big ballers and shot callers come to get, you know, their diamonds and things. Well, today our guest is sort of set the trend for this. He's been here forever. He almost needs no introduction because he bought you a teenage love.
Word. Now it might seem strange. You better take hints quick and make the right change. A teenage love.
He said, hey, young world, slow it down.
Righteous laws are overdue. And this is a message that the ruler Rick threw. And it's true.
Told us children's stories.
Y'all tucked in?
Y'all know who I'm talking about. Slick Rick the Ruler. The one and only Slick Rick the Ruler. Today, here on Rap City. Y'all stay tuned. We'll be back in a second. Just flossing. Just flossing. Yeah, we're still here at the Diamond Quasar, your man Joe Clair. We're awaiting the arrival of Slick Rick. And this is Jacob. He's pretty much the lacer of the stars. Now, can you tell me, why do the people come to you, man?
Why people come
to
me?
Yeah, why is this place so popular?
I guess I took the jewelry to the next level, you know? I started designing some year 2000 jewelry, you know?
Okay.
So be different.
Be different.
Yeah, now how like this.
Like, who was the first, like, major rapper or major star to come in? You remember?
First major rapper was Biggie Smalls.
Biggie?
Yeah.
Biggie came here.
Biggie.
And, well, you know what happened.
I have
Biggie
some
now.
Original pictures with Biggie.
Well, we're going to have to check those out.
Ago, yeah. And also, Biz Markie was one of the original.
Okay.
I made his first Biz ring, you know, the big
one. The big one?
Right.
Yeah, that, okay. Oh, okay.
Right.
Oh, okay. So, now everybody can come in. You don't have to be a star. He has pieces for everybody. He has all income levels. Can you point out some, like, major pieces to us real quick, man?
My latest piece here, I made this beautiful bracelet. It's about 42 carats in diamonds.
42 carats
in diamonds.
In diamonds.
Set in platinum.
Set in platinum. I don't even want to ask how much it costs.
Each stone is carat and a half, and the largest one is, largest ones are 3.5 carats each.
That's somebody's house. I'm gonna go ahead and put that back down.
Then I made this watch. Just finished it this week.
Please, would you please get the watch? Could you?
It's all invisibly set. Over 100 carats of Princess Cut diamonds in platinum. People ask me what I'm gonna name this watch because there's still no name. So I guess I'm gonna
name it. What are you gonna name it?
I made this from scratch, so I guess I'm gonna name it DQ.
DQ.
Diamond Quasar.
Diamond Quasar. Well, listen, y'all stay tuned. I'm gonna finish looking at some pieces. Hey, did you see this watch? What's this?
That's Cartier with original diamonds on it. Rolex with diamonds. Piaget with diamonds.
Yeah, y'all stay tuned. We'll be back in a minute. Joe Clair, just floss with my man Jacob today. Since we're here, and since this is out, we're gonna talk about jewelry right quick. Let's get into that.
Cause,
you know, rap music, everybody always had their chain, but it's like you took it to a whole nother level.
Yeah, all right.
You wanna speak on it for a second?
Well, yo, they on some platinum tip now, you know what I mean? So you gotta see Jacob. Jacob right here, 47th and 6th Avenue. Big Willie, got all the stars, you know what I'm saying? Haggle with him, he's working out, you know what I mean?
Word up.
And that's how it go, you know?
Word up. Now, please tell me that you haven't got rid of the Dookie.
Nah, I still got the gold, you know what I mean? I still got the gold, but, you know, I got to play both games. I play the platinum game, I got to play the gold game, too, you know what I mean? So.
You just check. Can we look at your, now, can we look at your piece? This piece right here? Now, that's...
That's lost one of my stones. Jacob gonna fix it for me, right, Jake? You got me on some reels. Yeah, Jacob.
How can you tell one joint gun?
I could tell.
Oh, you could tell.
Real close.
Yeah, one of them. You could tell. That's all the easy.
Well, look, I want to get into you because you got the new album.
Okay.
We got to talk about the new album. I want to talk about hip hop. We want to talk about your career, man.
Okay, not a problem.
All the ups and downs, everything. Is that all right?
Not a problem.
Y'all stay tuned. Rap City coming to y'all today from Diamond, Quasar. Getting our floss on. For real, for real. You know, incarcerated. Did you get to keep up with hip hop? Did you get to, you know, keep up with the trends, or was it like you just went into your own world?
Back then, it was Biggie Smalls making a ruckus, Tupac,
right.
Snoop. You know what I'm saying? They was making a ruckus while I was doing the little talk.
So you didn't miss a step at all. What did you tell them?
Right,
you kept up with everything, so on and so forth. From that time until like right now, how is what's the difference since you've been here longer than me? You know what I'm saying? And most of the people watching, most of the rappers that are out there, what's the difference now between now and then?
Back in our days, we was more on some happy-go-lucky party tip, you know what I'm saying? Now they be on some rah-rah tip, crazy, some gangster tip, some old selling mad drug tip, some old robbery tip, you know what I mean? Besides that, though, rappers get mad more money, though, you know what I'm saying? You know, a lot of businesses is using rap to sell a product, you know what I mean? Rappers is making movies, Will Smith, for example, Lauryn Hill getting 5 joints on the Grammys.
Right.
So, you know, things are moving up, you know what I'm saying? We just got to find our little boundaries, you know what I mean?
Are you still in the rap game for the happy-go-lucky, for the party? Is that why you still do it?
I do it because I love the craft, you know what I mean? It's like God gave me a gift. He said, yo, have your fun this route, you know what I mean? I used to be a mail clerk, you know what I'm saying, Joe? What up, kids? I was a mail clerk, little library clerk, police law firms, you know what I'm saying?
I was a mail dude. I ran the mail room at a TV station, Rick. I feel you. So I feel you. You take it, you going where you gotta go.
Yeah, so I was a little mail clerk, you know what I mean? And it just blew up. So, boom, man, everybody likes to see a star, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no wrong with looking good, you know what I mean?
No.
So boom, yo, they on some platinum tip now, so boom, might as well get the platinum tip. You know what I'm saying? Winga, 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 winga.
Now the name of your album is The Art of Storytelling. However, that is the name of a song off of Outkast album on which you were featured. Now, explain the Outkast hookup first and foremost.
Outkast, Click, they made a song called The Art of Storytelling, and they wanted to do a third verse, and they said, well, who not better than Slick Rick for storytelling? So I did they verse, the third verse on they joint, and you know politics, how that go. Labels say, you do one for me, I do one for you. So we did the street talkers on my album.
Skip the road to Rick, his face to slam, help clean up this land.
As a matter of fact, we got the video, we're gonna check it in a second. What made you name your album
The Art of Storytelling? The reason why I named it The Art of Storytelling is because it's first I was gonna name it the I Own America, but that didn't really fit the whole title of the album.
Right.
The Art of Storytelling fit it a lot better, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like, I like to tell stories, that's a part of my little you know, package.
That's how you get that.
So The Art of Storytelling, if you listen to the whole album, you can see it's like the art of telling visual pictures, you know, the whole shebang, you know what I'm saying? So it fit better, you know what I mean? Outkast and Cassie had no problem with it, so we went ahead and did it, you know what I mean?
Boom, and everything's lovely. Matter of fact, let's get into that video right now, Street Talk. Let's break up a piece of hip-hop myth. You and Dougie Fresh are not a group. Y'all are just two cats who did songs together. Hey, were y'all ever a group?
You know what it was? Dougie Fresh was already established, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
And he just put me on his ship for a second when we did Lottie Dottie in the show. It blew up. It, you know what it was? We didn't expect it to blow up like it did. It just like said, whoa,
dog.
So after that, it was like, the ship was like rocky, like what the hell, you know what I'm saying? I'm restarting the ship, kid, you know what I'm saying? So I said, look, I ain't gonna rock your boat, you know what I'm saying? Because you know how money gets split up, you know what I'm saying? I wanted like at least 40% or 30%, you know what I'm saying?
You gotta get your thing.
So I didn't want to rock the ship that hard, so I stepped off. And there wasn't no hard feelings or nothing like that.
Okay, for years, everybody like, yeah, there was a group. And then, you know, Rick went on and just was like, I don't mess with Dougie, you know. I was like, they were never a group. I tried to tell people wouldn't listen to them. So once and for all, that's all done. It's over with. But what you work with, bang.
Yeah, that's right, you know what I'm saying? That was my DJ, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, he doing his thing too now. He got two kids, the family man, all that, you know what I'm saying? Shebang.
It's kind of wild. People becoming family men now. Rappers are, you know, from when you were making records, but now got families and kids.
See what it is, Joe? We grew, yo, I'm like in the, you know, I'm in the 30 tip, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, yo, y'all look at it like this. When we was growing up, we was listening to rap. That don't mean we gotta, now we get older, we gotta be on some Smokey Robinson tip, not knocking. That, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because that's all fly too. But we ain't fall off the earth, you know what I'm saying? We just don't want to hear that rah-rah, I'm the greatest drug seller. You know what I'm saying? I'll snatch your mom's purse quick, fast.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? We just ain't on that. We older, we got kids, you know what I'm saying?
Because times has changed. And it's cool to look bummy and be a dumb dummy. Disrespect your mommy. Come on, man. Y'all tripping. Slick Rick doing our thing at the Diamond Quasar, having a flossy good time today. Who you feeling up in hip hop right now, man? Who turns you on?
I like, you see, I like different cuts from different folks, you know what I'm saying? Like Redman, he joined with Busta, you know what I'm saying? I like Missy joints, couple Missy joints. I like Lauryn Hill joints. All right. I like, I like Mobb Deep new joint.
Yeah, that Quiet Storm?
Yeah.
Yes, indeedy.
You know, Busta, Nas is decent. Right. You know what I'm saying? Raekwon, you know that's my man. He's making
ruckus. Do you hear your influence in any rappers? You don't have to name nobody, because you know they might be biting or whatever.
No, I wouldn't say. I would say they just still appreciate each other's work, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Each one teach one, you know what I mean?
Diamond Quasar, Joe Cleese, Slick Rick, the ruler of the day, just flossed out. I don't even think y'all TV sets could take all of this flossing we got going on today. So, you know, if we break TV sets, contact BET. I ain't got nothing to do with that.
Shoving up. Rick, let's talk about some of the other things you have going on besides, you know, being a rapper. You have the new album. You have other business ventures that you have gotten into. I understand you the landlord.
A couple bills in the Bronx, you know what I'm saying? Big shout out to Uptown, Eden Wabby. I got 2-3 family houses, you know what I'm saying? I'm the landlord, you know what I mean? I try to maintain them as best of my ability, you know? Every time I get a little dough, I always hook it up, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Try to make it look nicer and nicer. All the tenants get along, you know what I'm saying?
What's up with that? Because you know who else does that? Common Sense.
Okay.
What's up with that, man?
It's the thing to do, you know, you buy buildings, you know what I'm saying? You get tenants in it, you hook it up, lace it, so the tenants will come, you get good tenants, and you lace it, and when you finish paying off the mortgage, you can live off that money, you know what I'm saying, for the rest of your life. So you ain't like, you gotta work, you know what I'm saying? You buy a couple
like of... Like Monopoly.
Yeah, that's how it goes, because one day the rap thing might not work out for you, you know what I'm saying? And at least you got something to fall on. See, like my thing, if it ever works out, you know what I'm saying, when I pay off the mortgages and all that, I can live off like 6 tenants paying rent, you know what I'm saying? For
ever. Slick Rick the landlord. It's because it's more to the game than just the floss. The floss comes with thoughts. Hi, fam. Shaman Joe Cleese from the Diamond Quasar. Me and Slick Rick doing it up today. You got any, you know, last minute shouts? Anything you want to get right quick?
Shout out to the whole New York City, the whole planet, you know what I mean? Shout out to Joe Clear.
Word up.
Of course, Jacob. You gotta get Jacob in here. Let me tell you something, man. This guy be looking out for black folk big time. I'll say, you guys looking like this. Jacob, 47th or 6th Avenue. Good man. Haggle, kid. You know what I'm saying?
The album. What's up with the album, bro?
Album's in stores right now. All the storytelling. Bad conversational piece. Young and old. Ruckus. Go buy it. Peace. You know what I'm saying, Jake?
Definitely. Hey, security. Hey, where you going? I'm just going
to see about the light,
man. Yeah,
come back. Let's go.
You ain't got to be all up on my neck like that, man. Dang, y'all cold, man. Y'all going to take it off me on camera? Dang, y'all cold, man. Yeah, they do us, man. Can I keep this ring, man? Can I keep this? All right, don't break my arm, man. Can I put my Timex back on?
All right, get out of here.
I'm leaving, man. All right, you forgot this, didn't you?